Supreme Lord, Eternal Truth, let us obey Thee alone and deep according to truth. Paramocha Prabhu Satyam Nityatvameva Kevalam Anuvartamahe Satyam Anujivam Kevalam Om Shantihi Shantihi Shantihi. Good morning. Vande Mataram. Namaste. Welcome all of you. The topic of this morning's discussion will be on First Darshan of the Divine Mother, Part 1. Very interesting topic. So we have few great people who were the great sadhakas to the best of our understanding and to the best of our knowledge, whom we considered almost the disciple, real children of the Sweet Mother, of the Divine Mother. So they had their first darshan of the Divine Mother, and the experience what they have gathered in their life, they have described, or they have actually written in their own hands. And few such examples we will try to discuss in brief in this topic. The caption will be First Darshan of the Divine Mother. Of course, I will tell you, many people have finished their life till now. Many still are there on the platform, in this world, still they are existing. And the great people and some examples will be there among not so greats, and among the all-time greats, their experience of this first darshan of the Divine Mother, we were going to discuss in brief in this today's topic, first darshan of the Divine Mother. So we will start with Nalinda, the revered, the great yogi, the great sadhaka, the great coroner of this integral path, integral yogic path. We'll take his experience of the first darshan. And he writes here, in the beginning, Sri Aurobindo would refer to the mother quite distinctly as Meera. Already know, the mother was called Meera initially, her name was Meera. For some time afterwards, this may be expected over the period of years, we could notice that he stopped the sound of M and uttered the full name Meera, as if after a slight hesitation. Meera, M, then hesitation, and later it come to the original term Sri Aurobindo used as mother later. To us it looked rather queer at the time, that Nalinda expresses. Sometimes it looked like a queer at the time, but later we came to know the reason. Sri Aurobindo's lips were in the verge of saying mother, Meera, then M, then silence, and later Sri Aurobindo started quoting mother. But we had yet to get ready, so he ended with Meera instead of saying the mother. No one knows for certain on which particular date exactly, it was not known. The time is not expected and described in detail. At what auspicious moment that word mother was uttered on the lips of Sri Aurobindo, what Nalinda quotes. That exact point of time, the verge, the exact moment, not yet known. Nobody has decided or understood what was the real date. Nobody has marked it. But that was a divine moment of in unrecorded time. That was the divine name definitely. And this time also it is unrecorded, because this is only divine moment when the divine called the divine in the name of the mother. So a moment of destiny in the history of man and earth. For it was at this supreme moment that the mother was established on this material earth under the external consciousness of man. So Meera turned into the mother and got established on this material earth through the name, the supreme word, supreme. That was the supreme moment, and that was the supreme word, of course, in the destiny of the history of man and earth, in the external consciousness of the man what mother or ma, that word was pronounced, it came into existence. So secondly, we'll go and discuss the term after this thing. We'll very beautiful description by a French man. So mother study group, one of the members of the mother study group in Paris was well known as Tibetologist Madame Alexandria David Neal, one lady of course. She once spoke in the interview about those early days of the mother. We spent marvelous evenings, it was her version of course, we spent marvelous evenings together with friends, believing in a great future, believing in a great future. Of course, we have spent marvelous evenings together with friends. I remember her elegance, her accomplishment, her intellect endowed with mystical tendencies. She describes on her, on these glorious lines, on this magnificent wordings rather. In spite of her great love and sweetness, she quotes again, in spite of her great love and sweetness, in spite even her inherited age of musing, making herself forgotten after achieving some noble deed, forgetting she was forgetting, she could not manage to hide every wail and the tremendous force she bore within herself. This madam speaks of, this French lady speaks of, the tremendous force she bore within herself. The images in the, it was written of course in page 50-51, glimpses of the mother's life she has given. The mother was a sea of beauty and delight, originally the mother. Initially we have gone, the mother might brooded upon the world as per Nalinda's writing. So next we'll go Amrita, the great name as we have heard, the Amrita. So her experience we'll quote here. In 1914, I had the darshan of mother, Amrita speaks of. I could not perceive then that the mother was not an ordinary human birth. Her experience was there. Already mother quotes, the greatest gods are my children, even Krishna is also my children, and they are like kids before me. And then later she has told, of course, I'm like ordinary man, other human being. I have eyes, two eyes, two ears, one nose like this. But I endure, I move everywhere, I spread everywhere. And the latter, towards the end of this message, he has told, the people who have seen me the any way, the any form, whatever they have seen or they have expressed or they have spoken, everything is all right because I am that for them. So here Amrita speaks up. She, mother was not an ordinary human birth. In 1949, mother came for the first time to the land of India, the decreed respiratory of the spiritual riches. So just imagine the wording she used. In 1949, the mother came for the first time to the land of India, the decreed repository of spiritual riches. As directed by Sri Aurobindo in 1910, the mother reached Pondi on 29th March 1914, a few days after her arrival. John Vijayakanta introduced me to her, that's Amrita's wedding. Vijayakanta introduced me to her. How did he do it? He introduced me to the one of the students of the Kalbhe College and as one keen on practicing yoga. The mother lived in the house number 3, facing the north in Duplex Street. She had so much work to attend, so that she met people only at an appointed time. Mother had a lot of work to do. Only during the appointment only she was meeting people. Steps were taken even then to start the monthly review of Arya, both in English and French. The Arya publication, mother was actually taking care, instrumental taking the part there. Students from our school in small groups would come at their leisure hours to see mother, which we don't know then who the mother was really, because already Nalinda has expressed when the term mother Mira, from Mira, when this evolution from Mira to Mother, that auspicious moment, after auspicious, it is, of course, auspicious history not yet known. So, this is the Amrita's description. We meet the ecstasy of the Godhead stars in golden privacies of immortal life fire. So, again, we'll go for the description as described it by Datta. It is not generally known that Datta, then known as Miss Dorothy Hedgeson, her name originally, and after this name was she was changed to Datta, first saw the mother amongst the cherry blossoms of a garden in Japan. She was a professor in a college there. Initially that meeting was there. Then in the afternoon, the mother would visit the cherry garden. Very interesting. In the afternoon, the mother would visit the cherry garden. We met and spoke in the garden. At the first sight, I saw divinity in her. Initial very discussion, very talk to me, the point to be noted. I saw at the first sight the divinity in her. I adored and worshipped her like a goddess. But she would call me her friend. I used to carry her things, handbags, etc. When we became very close, I prepared salad for her. We would take very little food. We were together in 1920. When the mother was to return India, she asked me if I would like to accompany, so I came with her. That was the description, great description by great Datta. So many high gods dwelt in one beautiful form. So later we'll take the description as described in by T. Godandram Rao, T.K. Rao. So from that time I got the glimpse of Sri Aurobindo. I aspire to have his close darshan. How to get it at him? My friend had made me inquiries about the mother's residence, with about 200 yards away from the master's residence. Sri Aurobindo and mother, the residence was around 200 yards in between gap. And we soon got there immediately to have permission to meet the Lord. It was about 6 p.m. As soon as we entered the building, the mother was coming out of the house dressed in Western style on her way to Sri Aurobindo's house. So we were told later on, she was a serene personality with sweet transparent eyes. Just imagine the description. She was a serene personality with sweet transparent eyes. And we saluted her and requested an interview. She showed us into the presence of Mr. Paul Richard and went away smiling. So the luminous heart of the unknown is she, as described. So finally we'll take Mr. Purani. This time I saw the mother for the first time. She was standing near the staircase.